Now let's look at audio mixing using PR Control. First, I'm going to show the audio track mixer. I have that enabled. You can see the track names on the display. You can change the track name. I'll change this back to track 2, for example. And you see it updating here. You have 7 characters room, by the way. And if the text is too long, it's automatically compressed to fit. You can change the track flags. You see the state changing in Premiere Pro as well. You can see if I move faders, you see they're moving in Premiere Pro. This also works the other way around. I can move them using the mouse and the controller is updated. Now let's see if that works with automation. I've recorded some keyframes in this project. So I'll set this track to read. See it changing here. If I now play, you see the fader is moving. You can do this with more than one track. If I want to change multiple tracks at once, I can use a group. Then I can just select a couple of tracks and then change them with these buttons. So I change all of them to read. And I press play. You see them all moving. And you see here the state of the automation mode. If I turn all of them to write, you see write, latch, touch. But you could have a selection where there are multiple states. I'll show that. I'll turn off group. I put one in read mode, one in write mode, one in touch, it's already in touch, and one in latch. Now I enable the group again, and you see all of the buttons lighting up because all of these automation modes are present in the current group. If I now press latch, they all turn to latch and you get latch. And I can turn all of them off by first putting them in read mode. And I'm pressing read again. They'll all turn off. Okay, that was with the faders. I also want to show this with the panning. So let's turn off group. Use this track for panning. I'll set it to latch and I'll turn it to create some keyframes. You don't see them appearing live in Premiere Pro, but once you stop, you see I've got keyframes for pan. And if I go back and play, you see the pen moving here. Unfortunately, you don't see the pen change here, but that doesn't really matter because if you're changing it, it's always relative to the current value with these encoders. You can also use automation with multiple fader banks. So for example, if we're making a group, we can select all the tracks in this fader bank and go to the next one and select everything here as well. And now we can change the automation for all the tracks in this group. With PR Control, you can also use the clip mixer. I'll show the clip mixer here, and I'll have to enable it on the controller. On this controller, that is done with the global view button. Now you can see that it is enabled here as well. First, I will show a clip with some keyframes. You see the fader starts moving. If I want to write some keyframes, I have to enable it here. And then I can write keyframes. And when I stop, you see they are added. One thing to watch out for is that when you move the fader while playback is stopped, nothing happens. You have to start playback first. You go somewhere in your clip, start playback, and then move the fader. This is also true when you are not writing keyframes. Then you can only set the clip overall volume during playback. You can also record panning in the clip mixer. I've opened the effects panel so you can see the keyframes appear here later. I'll turn on write mode. I'll start playback and I'll use the encoder to change the panning to the right and all the way to the left and stop. And now you see the keyframes have appeared here. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.